Welcome back to the OpenVINO channel. From time to time, there is a new need to handle new set of topologies or other capabilities. Data scientists and other people who build and train neural networks develop new structures and new APIs. A great example is TensorFlow Object Detection API. This is an API built on top of TensorFlow. It makes it easy to construct, train, and deploy object detection models. And it is often used for very common topologies like SSD, Faster or Mask, RCNN, and others. We do support all of these topologies with OpenVINO. The problem is that when you're running inference in real time, the algorithm should be written in an optimal way for the hardware to execute it. Most hardware we use to accelerate neural network inference were built to accelerate direct acyclic graphs, meaning very structured graphs, as you can see here, for example. But when you look at the graph structure of an SSD model, for example, and I'm using here TensorBoard for viewing, you can see here the main function of the feature extraction, but also the preprocessor and the postprocessor. Getting into the preprocessor, you can see here that it has a while loop, which is great if you're programming, but not so great if this is part of a neural network. Same goes for the post-processing, which also have loops. So what the model optimizer is doing is to cut the loops in the graphs and replace them by higher level layers which do not have loops. If you will look at the same model after model optimizer, you will not find these loops. What we need to do is to help the model optimizer understand how to replace these portions of the graph, and this is done by two more arguments. The first one is TensorFlow use custom operations, and it uses a special JSON file to describe how to replace loops subgraphs. The second parameter is a pipeline config file. If you've used the model downloader to download the model, this file will already be there in the same directory. If not, these files could be found in the TensorFlow training environments. Let's do an example together. First, I will download a model using our model downloader. I'm downloading MobileNet SSD V2. And I have the TensorFlow files. You can see them here. And now we're looking for the JSON file. They are all located here. Let's look for SSD V2 support JSON file. You can see here the instructions on how to handle the preprocessor block, for example, and so on. The second file we need is a pipeline config file, and it is already downloaded for us. You can see here all the models parameters that the model optimizer need for its work. And we are running model optimizer. This is our model. This is our JSON file, SSD V2 support. This is the pipeline config file, and it's running. And you can see here the model optimizer tells us that the preprocessor block was removed, and we have the IR files, XML and bin. Now, let's just make sure the model is working. I'm copying the Python object detection demo. Let's run it. This is my input video. I'm using the converted XML file, and since this is an SSD model, I need the CPU extensions, and it's running. So we saw how to convert a TensorFlow object detection model. Use it. Subscribe to our channel to get more videos like this one. Thank you.